Now, before we delve into the details of how to tackle the English Language Paper 1 portion of your EdExcel English language exams, let's have a look at the general structure of this paper. As I always mention, it's really important to understand more broadly the structure, essentially what you are aiming for and what the end goal is, which is basically the exam, before we delve into the details of some past paper questions and I'll show you how to write top level 9 responses. Now, when it comes to the English Language Paper 1 exam, it's split into two general sections. The first tackles the fiction imaginative story that you are presented with, so you get an extract which you have to answer questions on, and the second section is basically the imaginative writing or the writing portion of the paper. Now for section A, I usually recommend for those questions in section A spend around an hour, and this includes time spent reading the extract, and then for section B it's good generally to spend about 45 minutes, and of course this whole paper is an hour and 45 minutes. Now, as you can see behind me, essentially I've just created a brief chart of what to anticipate for this paper, which I'm going to go over, okay? Now, as I mentioned, you've got section A and section B of this paper. Section A is generally you should try and spend 1 hour on it, and then as I mentioned, section B, you want to spend around 45 minutes on it. Now, in section A, you get a fiction extract. And for question one, which is just one mark, I usually recommend spending, to be honest, no more than a minute, if less, and you just write one brief sentence answering the question. So it's a very brief question which requires a brief sentence to answer it. Do not write a one-word response. That is not sufficient. Do you write just a sentence of a 5 or 6 words and that's enough, okay? Now, question two, which is worth 2 marks, you will have to write 2 statements in response to the question. Question three in this section is worth 6 marks, and this is a language and structure question. Do bear in mind that language refers to things like alliteration, metaphor, similes, nouns, verbs, adjectives, and so on. Structure refers to beginning versus ending of the passage, things like sentences, interesting punctuation, not full stops and commas, but things like ellipsis, things like a synderton, and so on, okay? Now, this question is basically where you touch on these elements in 6 marks. For question four, which is worth 15 marks, you usually get a statement, and you have to evaluate how successfully something is done in this statement. Again, this is just a walkthrough. I'm going to go over in detail exactly how to do so, and we're going to look at an example, okay? But that's really it for section A of the English Language Paper 1 exam to anticipate. Let's now look at section B. So as I mentioned, you should spend around 45 minutes. This includes planning. Now in section B, you have a choice of 2 questions. You have a question 5 and a question 6, and these are worth 40 marks. You choose just one. Do not do both questions. You just choose one, okay? Now, one of the questions, question 5 and question 6, it doesn't always come in this order. It's interchangeable, right? So this can either come as a question 6 or a question 5, okay? However, you'd have a question 5, which gives you 2 images. You choose one of those images and you write a story related to one of those images, okay? And then question 6, you can write about a time when dash happened, okay? Again, this is just a statement rather than an image, and then you write about it, and then you can, I would suggest, create a story around it, okay? And you can write a real or imaginary story. I would suggest try and make it interesting, exciting. Usually real life stories based on your own experiences maybe are not always as exciting unless you've led like a very exciting life. So I usually suggest writing just an imaginative story, okay? And as I mentioned, the image question can either be a question number 5 or number 6. So for example, if you see that the question number 5 is a statement, write about a time when dash happened, then the question 6 will be an image related question. It's interchangeable, but this is what you should anticipate, okay? So really, that's it when it comes to understanding the structure of English Language Paper 1, okay? So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk you through how the different past papers have looked like, and then most importantly, I will walk you through level 9 responses that I've created, so essentially model answers, and I will explain to you what makes them strong model answers. So let's begin.